This is a very, very important question, and particularly when we are to issue no objection certificate to any agency, whoever is seeking permission from us for construction of bridge over any national waterways in the country. Under these circumstances, we are to go through the standing procedure. We have classified the inland waterways in many categories. 1 to 7. In one category, the horizontal clearance from one pillar to the another pillar, minimum 30 meters is required. And vertical clearance is 4 meters. Likewise, in river Brahmaputra comes under category 7, class 7. So it requires 100 meters from one pier to the other pier. And that is horizontal clearance. And other parts, vertical is 10 meters. So this is the standing procedure. Accordingly, we follow it strictly. Thank you, sir.
Supplementary number 3, Susri Susmita Dev.
Thank you, sir. Sir, national waterways is an extremely important mode of transportation because actually it is much cheaper than railways and airways. I would like to ask the Honorable Minister through you that way back in 2016, a National Waterways Act was passed and 111 rivers were involved in it and declared as national waterways. Barak River in Assam was one of those rivers, sir. So we can send goods and bring goods from our neighboring countries, one of which is Bangladesh. I want the Honorable Minister to answer whether the national waterways of Barak River is functional, because my information is despite the infrastructure built there, sir, steamers are not running there. What is the reason for it?
Honorable Minister.
Respected Chairman, sir, in reply to the questions of two honorable member, Barak River is one of the most important international river. So this river is also a golden opportunity for the people of Northeast, particularly close to Barak Rivers. The adjacent states are Manipur, Mizoram, Tripura, etc., etc. And through Barak River, we can connect the Bay of Bengal through the Bangladesh Protocol route. So now, to make it navigationally feasible, and we are also planning to make the dredging with the principle of assured draft, so that whole the year, the seamless movement of cargo vessel can be made possible to Bangladesh and the rest part of the country. So accordingly, we have developed Patarkandi and also the Karimganj, the two terminals so far, and planning to dress the river according to the requirement of the cargo vessel seamless movement. Thank you.
Supplementary 4, Sri Milind Devda.
Sir, thank you. Sir, in addition to the point that the inland waterways or rivers are the most economical mode of transport, they are also the most environmentally friendly mode of transport as compared to roads and railways. So in the last decade, a lot of our cargo has moved onto the rivers and waterways. In fact, from 6.89 million metric tons 10 years ago, 133 million metric tons are being moved through the waterways, which is a very good initiative. But what is important for us to also measure is what is the percentage of our overall transportation mix that the waterways constitutes. So I had the good fortune of being a MOS in this ministry. 10 years ago at the time, only 1% of our cargo was moving through waterways. Today that percentage is 2%. Some countries in Europe, for example, Holland, over 50% of their cargo is moved through the rivers, which makes it very environmentally friendly and economical. My only suggestion, rather than a question, to the Honorable Minister would be, it's very, very critical to enhance the coordination with the state governments, because ultimately, sir, it's very, sir, my limited suggestion, It's very important to work, increase the coordination with the state governments, because if they don't build roads, they will automatically divert their cargo, especially in grains, fertilizers, to these waterways and make them more feasible. Thank you.
Honorable Minister, the supplementary is how you will act to optimally exploit the potential of waterways and reach a higher level. Honorable Minister, the chair has a right to ask. Yeah, that's right. Your point is well taken. Therefore, I'm asking. The suggestion is well taken.
Respected Chairman, Chair.
This is old friendship.
Respected Chairman, Chair.
Honorable Minister. Nothing is going on record.
Respected Chairman, Chair. Today, I am happy that most of the honorable members showing their keenness and interest to discuss about the waterways, national waterways. For your information, up to 2014, there are only 5 national waterways. And the availability of the resources, I believe the earlier government, I'm not criticizing you, but I'm just narrating the fact of happening, whatever like it was there during that time. So up to 2014, there are only 5 national waterways. Out of 5, only 3 were operational. So, but Honorable Prime Minister, after going through detailed study and research, have directed to this ministry that we should enact a new legislation, and with this we should take the suggestion of the state government, and going through the techno-economic feasibility report, ultimately there was an addition of 106 number of waters and got the recognition as a national waterways. Altogether it went to 111 now. Because of this transformational initiative of the Honorable Prime Minister, now look at the figure, which is very exciting for all of us. To reduce the logistic costs, I think this mode of transportation is the most feasible one. Globally, it is all being accepted. And during the period of 13-14, the total cargo annual transportation was 18.07 million metric ton, 2013-14. Now look at the figure, it is now 133 million ton, 2023-24. This is the success story. And this how proves that transformation ultimately created the ecosystem and ultimately inspired the people of all kinds so that they could take part in the growth of national economy and contribute remarkably. And this is the 6th time growth. Let me tell you, Honorable Finance Minister is sitting with us, very dynamic Finance Minister. So, for your information, in 2008-09, the total expenditure during their time, only 98 crores, total 98 crores. But in our time, it went up to 1,110 crores, 10 times more. That created the infrastructure, jetties, terminals, cargo vessel, passenger vessel, cruise vessel, all kind of vessels started moving because of the ecosystem. That is the kind of environment created because of the dynamic leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister. I'm really thankful to all of you whoever have shown their keenness to take part in this, and I believe we should all inspire the young generation to study the available resources in the water system in the country. And I believe in our rivers, this is the ecosystem we have got necessarily, and ultimately we have to simply, by putting our best possible effort and better technology, better wisdom, we have to create that ecosystem so that in the near future, India can become the most leading maritime nation in the world. Thank you.
So the Honorable Member Milind Devda asked thought-provoking, suggestive supplementary. Sri Sri Birendra Prasad Bese, supplementary number 5.
The mighty Brahmaputra, so through you, I want to know from the Honorable Water Waste Minister, your ministry have took any step.
Supplementary, sir.
Development. I am coming to the real supplementary, sir. For infrastructure development, long national highway of Assam to promote and enhance river tourism in India.
Honorable Minister.
Respected Chairman, sir, as you know, like in the recent past, there was MB Ganga Vilas, which cruise ultimately created history, because the MB Ganga Vilas, that is a river cruise, which has started its voyage from Banaras to Dibrugarh, crossing more than 27 river system and 3,200 kilometers. So this created history because earlier this was never happened. And people had an apprehension. They thought that Ganga mein pani nahi hai, jahaz phas jayega. Brahmaputra mein pani nahi hai, ye cruise nahi chal sakti. Aise logon ne tippini bhi ki, alochna bhi ki. Aur aakhir mein, mananiya Pradhanmantri ji ne jo nirdesh di, ki aise hame mahul khada karni honge, taki hamari nadi pe jo shakti hai aur hamare नदी के दोनों पार में हमारे सांस्कृतिक जो धारा है, हमारे सभ्यता सांस्कृतिक जो मूल्य है, इन चीज़ों को दुनिया देखे, दुनिया भारत को आविष्कार करे। उसी हिसाब से जब इन चीज़ों को ध्यानपूर्वक ली गई है, अल्टीमेटली रिवर क्रूज एमबी गंगा विलास ने ऐसा माहौल खड़ा किया, आप देश के अंदर एक का बदले 9 क्रूज चलने लगा है।
Further discussion on the working of the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. On 5th August 2024, Sri Amarpal Moriya had not concluded his speech while participating in the discussion. I now call upon Sri Amarpal Moriya to continue his speech. Sri Amarpal Moriya.
अध्यक्ष महोदय, कल सदन का समय पूरा होने के पहले कुछ समय मिला था। माननीय उपसभापति जी का भी मैं धन्यवाद करता हूं और आज पुनः समय मिला, महोदय इसके लिए भी धन्यवाद करता हूं। महोदय, मैं कल कह रहा था कि माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी ने बहुत छोटे छोटे कदम, जब से सरकार बनी है, उन्होंने केंद्रित किया और उसी दृष्टि में वो छोटे कदम बहुत बड़े नतीजे देते हैं। मोदी जी ने एक छोटा आंदोलन एलईडी बल्ब के लिए चलाया था और वो आंदोलन इतना परिणामकारी सिद्ध हुआ। उसका परिणाम ये निकला कि करोड़ों परिवारों को एलईडी बल्ब देने की जब योजना चली, उस एलईडी बल्ब के माध्यम से 45 बिलियन यूनिट ऊर्जा की बचत हुई। यह है नरेंद्र मोदी सरकार की दृष्टि। उन्होंने छोटे विषयों को केंद्रित किया और इतना ही नहीं महोदय, उन्होंने कहा विकास भी और